Well, how you doing, Motivation Church? I pray that you are doing well today. I'm excited for what God is doing in our church and in your life. Here's what I believe. I believe in the promises of God. And the promises are very simple, that He takes all things, and the word all, in the Greek translation, you know what it means? It means all. No matter what you're walking through, what God is doing is using that as ingredients to make something good out of it. So no matter if you're going through hardship, maybe you lost a loved one, maybe you're lonely, anxiety, depression, no matter what you're walking through right now, can I tell you that He's taking the ingredients of your life and He's making something good in your life today. I really believe it. I'm excited for what God's going to do and speak to you today. I really believe that this word is going to transform your life today. And I want to jump back into Nehemiah chapter 2. I feel like I've been in Nehemiah for the last 3 weeks, but Nehemiah 2 the last 3 weeks. But I really believe this, that God's going to speak something so fresh in your life today. But before I get to the word, I want to give you just a few different updates that we have in our church today. Number one is that I've been getting calls, and our leadership has been getting calls of when we're going to open the doors of our church. And I want us to know, as our governor has released us into phase one as a church and as a state, I want to let you know that we're going to take the next 2 weeks. Today is the first week, and then next week as well, to collect data. We're actually sending our team to some other churches that are open to figure out how to do it safely for you. And then we're going to assess, and it's my prayer and my hope that we're going to have a limited experience on Pentecostal Sunday. On Pentecost Sunday, I am super excited about that, on May the 31st. And so what that looks like is that we're only going to allow 150 people to come in on that day. And in fact, if you want more information regarding our reopen plan, I want you to go to motivation.church/reopen. In fact, there will be a link at the bottom of the screen right now. And you'll be able to see that so that you can see all the information that you need to know regarding our reopen. And you can register for that 150 persons service we're going to have on May the 31st. And again, once we hit that max, we won't allow many people to come in after that. We want to abide by the guidelines that's been given to us. And we're pumped and we're excited for what God's going to do. And again, that could change in light of new data that comes out. And so we are closely watching what our leaders and of our country and of our state is saying to make sure that we make the best decision to make sure that you and your family is safe. But I'm telling you what, we are going to worship again in this building, and I can't wait till that day happens. If you have your Bibles with you, if you turn to the book of Nehemiah chapter 2, I want to jump back into a passage. This is almost like part B of the week before last, of the word of God that I have. And this word has been stirring in me, this particular topic. I want to go to Nehemiah chapter 2. I want to read this one passage. It says this. Nehemiah chapter 2, starting in verse 17, it says, come, let us rebuild the wall of Jerusalem, and we will no longer be in disgrace, as I told them about the gracious hand of my God on me. And he says this, and the king that has been with me, and they replied, let us start rebuilding. So they began the good work of God. I want to read that last part to you. It says this, they replied, let us start rebuilding. So they began the good work of rebuilding. I want to let you know today, in fact, if there was a title of today's sermon today, it would be a groundbreaking ceremony. Come on, somebody. Groundbreaking ceremony. I don't know about you, but every now and then, we got to look at the plans that we have to rebuild our lives. We got to look at the prayers that to rebuild our lives. We got to look at like the promises of rebuilding our lives. And at some point of your life, you have to break ground. At some point, you have to say enough is enough. At some point, you have to say, I am sick and tired of being sick and tired. At some point, you have to break ground today. And I believe today will be the day where you break ground on the rebuilding project of your heart, of your marriage, of your family, of your future. God is going to break the ground today. Come on, somebody. You ought to say amen to that will. Come on. let me pray. The team wants to get off the stage. Let me pray. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I pray, God, that you may open our hearts. So, God, we can hear your word so clearly today. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Come on, we'll praise God. Thank you so much, worship team. You all are doing such an amazing job. Hey, right now, if you think they're doing an amazing job, can you give me some heart emojis? Some good job, Ed, Will, Jay up here, Jeremy, Willie Will on the drums. Come on, let's just kind of give them some heart emojis right now. Come on, somebody. They are so awesome. Man, praise God. Hey, Will, are you still single? Are you single right now? Hey, right now, everybody, this man right here behind me, this white chocolate-looking brother right here is single on the market. Come on, somebody. If you like how you look, come on, comment right now. I'm just playing. Don't comment right now. Oh, gosh. Oh, they might cut that part out, everybody, but I hope they leave it in. I'm excited for the word of God today. I really believe that God's going to speak right to us. And, you know, I entitled this groundbreaking ceremony because, you know, I was a part of a couple of building projects in my lifetime. Some were churches and some were businesses. And every groundbreaking project and every groundbreaking ceremony, it was the time where we declared that there was no going back to this building project. It was a time where we said, no matter what's happening, no matter what's going on, we are breaking ground and it is about to start. And I just think that this is a moment that we need to have. In fact, Nehemiah and the people of God had that moment. They had prayed for many years for the rebuilding of the wall. They had planned for many years for the rebuilding of the wall. They had started this process for the rebuilding of the wall. But here's the greatest part about all that stuff. No matter what they were going through, they had to say to themselves, it is time to rebuild. They broke the ground. And I just really believe this, that we're living in a culture where we love to talk about things, right? Right? Like we love to post about things. We love to pray about things. And that's so awesome. And we love to plan. And planning is so needed. But at some point of your life, you need to go see that counselor if you're having emotional issues. At some point in your life, it's time to knock down that debt in your life. At some point in your life, it's time for you to go back to school. At some point, the planning, the promises, and the waiting needs to end, and the ground needs to be broken in your life. It's time to break the ground today. I really believe it, that God wants to start it today. And I'm not trying to prophesy God's timing over your life, but here's what I do know. I do know is that God is a God who is always moving and always doing something new in your life. He's always building something new in your life. Today is a day where you break the ground. I want to give you a few points about a groundbreaking ceremony and at what we see in the book of Nehemiah. The book of Nehemiah is a book where it was charged to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Previous to Nehemiah, the people of God had went through all type of captivity. They were going through all types of things. And they went through the Assyrian captivity, and they end up getting freed, and they're back in Jerusalem. The wall is knocked down. The temple is broken down. So the book of Ezra is about the rebuilding of the temple, where the book of Nehemiah that we're in, it's about the rebuilding of the wall. And so we see that in this book that they are starting the building project and now they are breaking the ground. They are saying, let's get started. It is time to work. And I pray that today could be a day for your life that you can say, let's get started. Let's start to rebuild the broken things in our lives. So here in this passage of scripture, we see that, and it kind of reminds me of that New Testament passage of scripture. You guys know in the book of James, chapter 1, verse 22, it says this, don't just merely listen to the word. Don't just hear the good sermon. Don't just hear the preacher on Facebook Live, or on YouTube Live, or on a website, or on a repost. Hear the preacher saying that God has a plan for your life. Don't just listen to the word. But the Bible says in James 1, 22, at one point of your life, you need to do what it says. I mean, you just need to do it. Come on. Come on, right now. You just got to tell your neighbor right now, just Do it. Just break the ground. There are a few things that the people of God in the book of Nehemiah chapter 2 did. And I believe that what we need to do, and I believe that happens at every rebuilding project or building project. What happens after you break the ground, number one, you first remove the old ground. You remove the old ground. And what Nehemiah did, as he inspected the wall, he took all the broken pieces of the wall and he removed it, right? Because here's what I know, you can't build anything great and new on some old practices. In fact, I love what the Bible says in the New Testament when Jesus was talking to the religious people and they wanted the newness of God, but they had the old way of thinking, right? You guys remember that passage of scripture? It says that God can't pour new wine into old wineskins. Here's why. Because if you pour the new wine into the old wineskins, the new wine would burst the old wineskins. And I come to declare right now that if you're going to start a brand new building project in your life, you have to remove the old ways of thinking. You have to remove the old behavior. If you're believing God right now for a new marriage and you've been through stuff in your past, can I tell you, you got to get rid of the old practices because you can build a new marriage on old practices. And can I tell you and prophesy some bad news over you? It will end up the same. Can I tell you, when you break ground, you get rid of that initial dirt. You get rid of that ground that was already there because you got to get rid of the old. And I think it is time for the people of God to repent of our sinful ways, to repent of our negative ways, of our negative thinking, of our faithless ways. And we got to say to God, God, I'm ready to get rid of the old. And that's what repentance is. Repentance is turning around from the old way of living and walking towards a new way of living. And when you turn around from your old way of living, you create the foundation that God can build on. Can I encourage you today that it's time to get rid of some old habits? Maybe you got some negative friends in your life, and when you're hanging out with those group of people, you go around the same path. Maybe you have the same drinking habits, the same inappropriate website habits. And God says, I'm waiting for you to remove the old ways so that I can build something brand new in your life today. It is time for you to remove the old so that God can start to rebuild the new in your life. I think oftentimes, like, we're just complaining to God and waiting for God. God, when is this going to happen? God, when am I going to get a raise? When God says, I can't give you a raise and pour new money on your life because you don't know how to deal with the money that you have right now. I need you to upgrade your budget and your systems of handling money, and then I will be able to pour more of my blessings on your life. You got to get rid of the old. I mean, oftentimes in life, oftentimes what we do is that we wait around, waiting on the new while we're sitting in the old. And I cannot tell you, while you're in a waiting period, you should be removing old stuff, old habits, old ways of thinking, so that God can have the foundation to pour something new in your life. Byron, I'm preaching this word today. I hope somebody got this word today, Byron. I pray that they get it in their spirit today, that you don't matter, no matter who you are today, God says you got to get rid of the old. And I'm even examining my own heart. God, what in my life needs to go so that you can bring something new in my life? God, what in my life needs to go away so that you can pour out your new blessings in my life? God, I'm asking God, what needs to go? I mean, even Jesus, he was the Son of God, and he was the newness of the Spirit, and the old religious leaders, they could not handle Jesus because they were so stuck in their old ways of thinking. And I think that sometimes what we're doing is that we're so stuck in the old ways, and even for me, can I be transparent with you as a leader? Sometimes I ask God, God, what are we going to do as a church? God, what are we going to do? Like, how's the church going to survive in the post-COVID world? And God, we used to do things this way. God, we used to do things that way. And God says, if you're ready for the new, get ready for the new. Like, you got to remove the old. But the second point that happens after a groundbreaking ceremony is that not only do you remove the old dirt, but what you do is that you level the current foundation. Like you level, you gotta make sure that it's even, that it's level, that there's balance, that there's balance. And I come to declare right now, some of you right now, you don't have balance in your life at all. It's just no balance at all. And maybe some of you, you're working really hard and you're trying to provide for your family, but you're not there at all to put your kids in bed and raise your kids in the way of the Lord. And maybe some of you are over here and you're just home a lot. Home too much. You need to get out of the house and start working and provide for your family, right? There needs to be balance in life. And what I'm come to realize in life, that life is about how you can find the balance. You know, balance is really not about like this, but it's more about like what you put weight to, right? Like, and maybe some of you're putting too much weight to what you hear in the news cycle and not enough weight to the good news of the gospel of Jesus. And so you're not balanced at all. And so you're responding to events of the world. And one week is this and the next week is this. And it's like all you're thinking about is the events of the world. And you have not thought about the good news of the gospel. Can I tell you that you need to know what's going on in your world, but you need to know what's going on in God's world. There needs to be balance. And when you level the foundation of your life, when you level the foundation of your marriage, of your home, of your finances, of your career, when you begin to have balance in your life, then God will be able to pour in brand newness in your life today. Come on, we got to have some balance today. I mean, maybe some of you've had no balance at all. It's been social media, Netflix, Hulu, and it's been like that for your entire day. But can I encourage you? It's something called screen time on your phone. You can lock yourself out after a certain period of time of spending on social media, because some of us right now, if we can be honest, there's no balance. It's just you hear the voices of the world way more than you hear the voices of God. Some of you, when it comes to your time, like there's no balance. Like you're out busy enjoying yourself, but there's no time in God's word. Like there needs to be a sense of balance in what you put your weight to. If I can be transparent with you, there are moments when I realize that I'm at home laying in the bed and having many anxiety attacks and freaking out because, you know, maybe something's out of control here at the church or something's unknown here at the church. And I just have all these moments when I'm like, God, what am I doing? And God clearly spoke to me and said, Travis, stop worrying about something that I've already done. And oftentimes when it comes to our mental health and the health and having healthy emotions, a lot of times we get into negative places because there's just no balance. Can I tell you that God's looking for people who have balance? And so in the building process, you see that Nehemiah, he went around in chapter 2, right, after they declared to rebuild the walls, right? He went around and he began to inspect the wall and make sure that it was no rough places, the Bible said. There was no places where it was uneven. He had to make sure that the ground and the existing wall was even. It had to be leveled. It had to be balanced. And he couldn't start the newness of the project until there was balance in the current state of the ground and of the wall. And can I encourage you today that God can't start nothing new until he discovers and sees some type of balance in our lives. I think we're just running, especially here in America. It's hard to find balance. We're just driven. Maybe some of you rest too much, and some of you have not enough rest. Some of you, you're just going at it, and you're just not taking care of yourself, and you're just going. Some of you take care of yourself way too much, and you're not doing enough for other people. Can I tell you, there needs to be balance. I think even now, I think there needs to be moments where you need to be quiet and balance your soul. God, how's my soul doing today? I think it's so important to do that. You know, and you know, the devil really uses areas in your life that are not balanced. He attacks it. So if it's spending too much time at work, if it's not enough balance in your marriage, if it's not enough balance in your kids, not enough balance in your finances, he uses any area that you don't have balance for his good and not for the kingdom of God today. So make sure you have balance in your life. Not only do you need to remove the old ground, And not only do you need to have balance in your life, my last point today is this, it's simple, is that whenever there's a groundbreaking ceremony, old ground is removed, balance is created, leveling is created, and then the newness of concrete comes in. New dirt comes in, new ground comes in, so that foundation can be strong today. Can I encourage you all today that God just don't want you to stop living a certain way and take away certain things from your life? What he really wants to do is add to your life. That's just why I love the New Testament, right? The New Testament is very electric and alive, because what the New Testament does is that not only do we need to rid ourselves of sin and negative ways and negative thinking and of fear, but what he's going to do is that he's going to pour something on the inside of us. He's going to pour his Holy Spirit on the inside of us. And I love the book of Acts chapter 2. And the people of God were up in the upper room, and they were praying to God. And the Bible says that something like a mighty rushing wind began to pour down on the people of God. What he was doing was he realized that the old thinking was gone and balance was created. Now they were ready for the newness of the Spirit of God. And can I encourage you all today, no matter what you're walking through, God wants to pour something fresh in your life. He wants to pour the living water in your life today. He wants to not leave you empty, but he wants to fill your cup today. In fact, I'm reminded of this story in the Gospels, where there's this lady at the well, and she was at this well, and she come at this well, and the Bible says that she came with an empty bucket trying to fill her well, but we know that her bucket really wasn't empty. It was filled with shame. It was filled with condemnation. It was filled with pain, loneliness, regret. The Bible says that she come at this well and she come to fill her bucket, and then she meets this guy. His name is Jesus. And Jesus meets at this well, and Jesus says, I know you're going to fill your bucket with this water, but the water that I want to give you is everlasting. And you will never thirst again. You will never have moments of wanting anything else again. You whenever God fills you today, you will never thirst again. And I just have the suspicion that a lot of you are watching this video today and you are empty. If you could be honest today, you could be honest with yourself, empty. You're running on E right now. You get mad fast, short comments, things bother you, fear is high, anxiety is high. There's no faith. There's no grit in you. There's no let's build a kingdom in you. There's no let's charge my purpose in you. It's just there. A lot of you are empty right now. Can I tell you, let you know right now, that before God starts to rebuild in your life, before you start to walk out your purpose, before you start to live out your destiny today, can I tell you today, what he wants to do is pour his Spirit over your life. And check this out. When the Spirit of God is your foundation, whatever you build on it will last. Can I tell you today, it's time to put God at the foundation of your life today. Maybe fear has been your foundation. Maybe today, if you can be honest right now in the chat, maybe anxiety has been your foundation. Maybe if you can be honest right now, maybe it's greed that's been your foundation. It never lasts. But when you allow the Spirit of the living God to fall on your life today, when you allow the Spirit of the living God to say, fall afresh again. Come on. It's time for some of you to have a baptism of the Holy Spirit right now. Right in your living room, right in your car. It's time for you to ask the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, fill me once again. Pour down new foundation again. God, pour in the newness of who you are again. Come on, right now, ask God. Ask God to fill you. Ask God to fill you. And when he fills you, you'll never be the same. So today, right now, it's a groundbreaking ceremony. It's time to break the ground. It's time to get rid of the old. Time to level the ground, level your life, balance your life. And it's time to let the Holy Spirit pour in brand new concrete over your life so you can have a strong foundation. I believe it right now. In fact, if you're here right now watching this video, you want to respond to God today. You take your next step. In fact, there's a number below. Every week we have people text this number below. Every week. We haven't had a week yet since we've done this live stream that someone hasn't responded to the gospel. Today, if you want to respond to the gospel, right now you say, I'm empty. I have no hope in life. I want to let you know there is hope for you. You don't have to remain empty. You don't have to remain broken. There's a great carpenter, and his name is Jesus, and he comes to put your life back together again. So right now, text that number. It's time to respond. Maybe you're a seasoned Christian here today. You've been following God for a long time, but you can be honest, you're empty. You need an outpouring of the Holy Spirit to recharge you, to fill you up, to have a level foundation again. If that's you right now, come on, respond. Text the number. We want to pray for you. We want to know what you're walking through. In fact, in the comment, if you want prayer, come on, we want to pray for you. We want to walk with you. We really believe this. No matter where you are in your walk with God, you can be following God for a long time or you haven't started yet. Today, I want to let you know that God wants to rebuild. So as the Word of God says in Nehemiah, let's get started with the rebuilding project of our lives. Let me pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray a blessing over every single soul that's watching this video. Lord, bless them today, God, as they respond to God. I pray, God, that like never before, that you start something new in them. Get rid of the old, God, old ways of thinking, habits, negative ways, and pour in something brand new in their lives. And God, I know that we're all going to be better because of it. In Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise, y'all. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hey, we love you, Motivation Church. We see you online next week. God bless you, Motivation Church.